I refuse to let them run from the expectation.
This carries back to the warning track. Say goodnight to it. Grand slam home run.
As ugly as we played the last couple of games, our effort and our attitude have been right.
Every day is a new day, and we've kind of started to see that. And as y'all know, we needed one, that's for sure.
You know, there's nothing more gratifying than to see how people grow and see how life changes.
I honestly feel I'm the best DB out there.
The first thing that stands out when you see him physically is his size and length.
I think the biggest thing to take away is just you got to finish teams and you have them.
Since I've got here, it's been a lot of change. So I'm looking forward to having some of the same guys back.
It took until day three for a Texas Longhorn player to hear his name called at the NFL draft, but two Longhorns found themselves on NFL teams, one reuniting with an old teammate. More on the draft in minutes.
I had this bat in my locker for all year. I haven't swung it at all. I brought it out to change things up today or this week during BP, and I decided I liked it. So I used it for the first time in the game today, and first swing, hit a home run with it. So I'm stimulating from here on out.
Texas snapped its six-game losing streak today thanks to a freshman and a lucky bat. Welcome to Sports Sunday. I'm Cameron Parker. For four straight games, Texas entered the ninth inning with at least a share of the lead. All four of those games ended with a Longhorns loss. Swept in back-to-back series and on the verge of it happening again, the Longhorns freshman came up big. Ford Trucks is, quote, the best in Texas. Maybe Ford's bat is, quote, the best in Texas. First pitch to Lance Ford, and he sends it out to the country roads. Lance Ford's first career home run puts the Horns up 2-1. Fourth inning now as Eric Kennedy hits one off the pitcher and brings it home. A run, Longhorns up 6-2. And then in the seventh, Lance Ford again. Ford. The freshman launches a grand slam, six RBIs, two home runs, and Ford puts the Longhorns back in the win column with a much-needed 10-2 victory over West Virginia.
It's special. I mean, it's something that nobody's given up, and I think it's easy to start pointing fingers, and our guys haven't done that. They did a good job of just not allowing it to spiral past today.
That's been a long time coming. That's our first Big 12 win in a while, and we needed that one a lot. And I think it does kind of free up some tension because we have been pressing for that win.
Every day in that clubhouse has been positive energy, and I think that's what's huge about this. We haven't been getting on to each other too much and just taking care of our own jobs.
Regardless of what happens to the Longhorns this postseason, David Pierce hopes he found something in freshman pitcher Ty Madden. Madden pitched six innings, giving up just one earned run in the Longhorns' victory.
It's been a grind, that's for sure. I mean, beginning of the year, just stepping on campus, you gotta learn that at this level, you gotta learn how to pitch instead of throw. Coach has been real good about getting on to me, and all year I've had to be flexible. I mean, I've had to start, had to close, and that's kind of what they told me at the beginning of the year, that expect to do whatever, and so I've kind of adapted to that, and hopefully I'm getting a rhythm now.
With only two conference series remaining, Texas possibly finds itself not only on the outside looking in for the NCAA tournament, but also the Big 12 tournament. The Longhorns traveled to Kansas this weekend in a pivotal matchup for their postseason hopes as only the top eight teams in the Big 12 advance to the conference tournament. James Harden led the league in free throw attempts this year, 161 more attempts than Giannis Antetokounmpo, who was second. But the Rockets MVP candidate could not draw three more in a controversial ending to game one against the Warriors. Rocket Warriors, a rematch of last year's Western Conference Finals, this time in round two. Longhorn legend Kevin Durant throws it down off the pass from Steph Curry. Durant finished with 11 points in the first half, but ended the game with 35. Rockets aren't going anywhere, though, down just three until Steph Curry knocks this down from three. Do the shimmy. But less than 10 seconds left to go in the game, James Harden will miss the step back. Chris Paul gets the rebound, throws it out of bounds. He won't get a foul. Harden wants the foul. They won't get either. Warriors will get game one. And while the refs may have swallowed their whistle, Harden did not hold anything back.
What can I do about it? I was told the same thing at half, and there's probably a couple more in that second half. I just want a fair chance, man. Call the game how it's supposed to be called, and that's it. And I'll live with the results. But when you, especially we all know what happened, you know, a few years back with Kawhi, like that can change an entire series. Just call the game how it's supposed to be called, and we'll live with the results. And it's plain and simple.
Denver Nuggets last played in the Western Conference Finals in 2009. The Portland Trail Blazers, 2000. One of these teams will advance to the Western Conference Finals starting tomorrow night. In the Eastern Conference, the Celtics were considered a disappointment all year, but did not disappoint today with an absolute trouncing of the Bucks in Game 1. Kawhi Leonard finished with 45 as Toronto took Game 1 against the 76ers. Some Spurs fans may still be recovering from Kawhi's departure. They still are recovering from last night's Game 7 loss to the Nuggets. San Antonio led the series twice, both 1-0 and 2-1, before Denver closed out the series, ending the Spurs' playoff run early. For the second straight year, the Spurs were bounced in the first round, sending Coach Popovich back to his vineyard earlier than he would like, or maybe not. Either way, the Spurs will look to learn from this loss and come back next year fully healthy.
I think the biggest thing I'm going to take away is just you got to finish teams when you have them. I mean, who knows what would have happened, but if we would have won those couple games, I don't think we'd be in this predicament.
Since I've got here, it's been a lot of change. So definitely looking forward to having some of the same guys back and, you know, having something to build off of and, you know, try to make it better.
With the 161st pick in the 2019 NFL Draft, the Houston Texans select Charles Omenahu, defensive end, Texas.
Omenahu? Charles Omenahu was born in Houston, but spent only 1 year there before moving to Dallas. Now the former Texas Longhorn is returning to where he was born, this time as a member of the Houston Texans.
So blessed to be drafted by a great organization like the Houston Texans. I'm just ready to get in, get to work, be a sponge to the veterans and guys that have been there before me, and just make my way and be a huge part for what's coming in Houston, man. Thank y'all so much.
Maybe also give your new teammates a pronunciation lessons. Texans new GM Brian Gain and head coach Bill O'Brien see some power in the rookie the Longhorn fans witnessed for 4 years.
The first thing that stands out when you see him physically from the profile, the physical profile, is his size and length.
You've got a guy there that had 9.5 sacks this year at Texas, played a lot of different spots up front for Texas. And, you know, the more you can do really helps your value. And that's what we looked at with Charles.
With Omenahu being drafted in the fifth round, the next and only other Longhorn drafted by cornerback was cornerback Chris Boyd by the Minnesota Vikings. Boyd will reunite with former teammate Holton Hill in the land of 10,000 lakes. Chris Boyd and Holton Hill committed to Texas together exactly 4 years later from the day Boyd was drafted on April 25th, 2015. Boyd and Hill will now play on the same NFL team. While only two Longhorns were drafted, eight others signed as undrafted free agents, including little Jordan Humphrey by the New Orleans Saints. Humphrey decided to leave Texas after his junior year. Patrick Faje and Anthony Wheeler also invited the rookie camps, Faje to the Ravens and Wheeler to the Chiefs. ESPN's Mel Kiper Jr. gave the Cowboys a draft grade of B-. Dallas used their selections to add much-needed depth on both sides of the ball. Add Amari Cooper, who was traded for the Cowboys' first-round pick, and it looks like a successful draft for Jerry Jones. Two of those picks were used to add some depth to the backfield. Memphis running back Tony Pollard was selected in the third round, and Ohio State's Mike Weber was drafted in the seventh. Weber spelled Zeke at Ohio State and will have the opportunity to do it again, this time in a Cowboy uniform.
Prudence tells you you need to manage this, and these guys let us manage Zeke in a manner of speaking. This Pollard really gives us some juice from the running back position, and he gives us legitimate options that threaten defense. The same thing is true with Weber.
You know, a guy like a Pollard can really come in there and be a great complement to Zeke in terms of what he can do.
How life changes just because you're a mentor, or you're a teacher, or you're there for them when they have a problem.
Still to come, how Hendrickson High School was represented at the NFL Draft on Friday. You don't want to miss Coach Coop. Plus, the Stros get stymied early. How one false move from Cleveland opened the door for Robinson Chirinos. That's up next. But first, tonight's Sports Sunday Stumper. Since 1967, which four NFL teams have drafted the most Hall of Famers? We'll answer that later in the show.
Hi, I'm James Brown, host of the NFL Today and Inside the NFL on Showtime, and you're watching Sports Sunday.